During Apple's WWDC 2021, they announced a slew of new iOS 15 features. So here's what to expect from iOS 15, including a bunch of updates to FaceTime, messages, notifications, and more. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today we're breaking down the best iOS 15 features that Apple just announced at WWDC 2021. So let's go. According to Apple, there's a whole lot to expect from iOS 15. So let's start with some of the changes to FaceTime that Apple is hoping will make FaceTime feel more lifelike. Users will notice spatial audio when having a FaceTime chat. So the audio from others is going to sound like it's coming from different locations. And Apple hopes this will make group conversations a little bit easier to follow. And another handy feature will be mic filters. So you'll be able to toggle on something called voice isolation in order to block out background noise on your end, which is really cool. Now, conversely, you'll also be able to toggle on full spectrum audio if you want your mic to pick up your surrounding audio. Now, there's a few other FaceTime features that are gonna make it feel honestly more like Google Meet or Zoom, starting with grid view. Yes. So group calls will now be displayed in the very familiar grid format. So you'll see each participant as their own little tile or square on the screen, and you're gonna be able to rearrange those tiles too. But that's not all. You're also gonna be able to blur your background on FaceTime using portrait mode. Yes. This is a feature that every person who's ever been on a video chat seems to absolutely love. And lastly, you'll be able to schedule your FaceTimes ahead of time in the calendar app and invite others via shared links, just like with your traditional video conferencing platforms. You'll love to see it. And speaking of FaceTime, update number two of what you can expect from iOS 15 is that FaceTime will now work in a web browser. Now, this clearly fits in with Apple wanting to keep up with the video conferencing competition. And here's the thing, FaceTime on your browser will even work on Windows and Android devices. Say what? So this is really important since you'll be able to schedule and share those FaceTime invites like we talked about for upcoming calls. Now you're gonna be able to share with friends regardless of whether or not they're even on iOS. So moving on to iOS 15 update number three, SharePlay. This is going to allow users to hold group FaceTimes to all watch something together or share your screen if you're wanting to give a presentation. Wowza. So all the shared media is synced and it can be controlled by all the users on a call. Now you can also send SharePlay videos to your Apple TV devices. So this means you're gonna be able to watch or listen to media from, you know, Apple AirPlay, Apple TV, Apple Music, Disney Plus, ESPN Plus, HBO Max, Hulu, Twitch, and just the list goes on and on. It's pretty neat. Okay, iOS 15 update number four, new shared with you lists. This one's pretty neat. So, you know when people send you URLs or media links in messages? Well, now those links will automatically be added to a shared with you list that's gonna be found in a number of different apps. So the links can be saved to, you know, say the news app, Apple Music, Safari, Apple TV, and Apple Podcasts as examples, and also the Photos app, I believe. And you'll be able to pin a link within messages in order to add it to the top of your shared with you section. So it's just a handier little organization option for all of those media links and URLs. And number five, Apple has announced new Do Not Disturb updates and a focus mode. In fact, Do Not Disturb will now be part of this new focus mode, which lets you block notifications from certain apps and pause just specific features. So you could create different focus profiles, like say a work focus, where you block out things like YouTube and social media, but not block out mail or other productivity app notifications that you might need for work. And cooler yet, your contacts will get a notification that you're in focus mode or do not disturb mode in certain apps. And may I interrupt this list to ask you a favor? If you are finding this content valuable, go ahead and give this video a like or consider subscribing to my YouTube channel for more content like this. I'd really appreciate it. And now we head back to our regular scheduled programming. Coming in at number 6 on what to expect from iOS 15, all new notification summaries. Expect your notifications to feel a little bit different in iOS 15. So, for example, notifications from people will now appear higher on your notifications list, and you're also going to be able to choose how you want to receive notifications. So, if you get overwhelmed with notifications, you can choose to receive them as a summary sent at specific times of the day. And you'll still have important ones from contacts appear immediately, but other ones that aren't as important will be sent at your chosen time. All right, number 7 on the list, live text. This is gonna be a helpful one indeed. This feature scans photos for words and converts them into selectable text. So think logos, handwritten notes, photos of instructions or street signs, recipes, anything like that. You'll be able to copy the text and then paste it into other apps. Or, you know, you could make your business name or number into a searchable link. By the way, this works with old photos on your phones too. I know personally, I take pictures of business cards all the time, so this would be really handy to be able to copy out, you know, those contact details like name and number and add them to my contacts on iPhone. Now, live text currently supports 7 languages and it's going to be available across devices. So think iOS, iPad, and Mac. Okay, this next iOS 15 feature has me all in my feels. Number 8, there's going to be major updates to your photo memories. Using Apple Music, you're now going to be able to add music to your photo and video highlight reels in Apple Photos. How neat is that? You can even pause or skip the video while the music's playing, and the video will adjust on the fly to fit the tempo. It's pretty awesome. Number 9 on the list is for my US friends. You'll be able to store keys and IDs in Apple Wallet. So, what does storing keys actually mean? Well, Apple's working with some digital lock manufacturers to allow users to store their, you know, digital work IDs, say hotel ID cards, even your digital house keys, in your Apple Wallet. Now you'll be able to scan and store your state ID cards in Apple Wallet as well. There is a caveat here though, and that's that we don't yet know which states are going to allow this, but I'm guessing California is going to be one of them, who knows. Now all keys and IDs will be encrypted and they're stored locally on your device, just like all Apple Wallet cards that you already have. And rounding out our list of what to expect from iOS 15, coming in at number 10, are Apple Maps updates. Oy vey, where to start with Apple Maps? Forgive me, Father Google Maps, for I have sinned just for uttering those words. But regardless of my feelings of maps, there are some updates worth mentioning. I mean, I guess. First, Apple is adding more transit details like traffic lights, bus, bike lanes, and crosswalks. And these are going to be not only visible in the app, but on CarPlay as well. Second, you'll be able to track and pin your most used public transit routes and then have those updates from your favorite routes sent directly to your Apple Watch, which is really handy for when you're on the go. And last, Apple Maps is finally launching AR directions. Yeah, you know, even more of the features Google Maps has had for years, but I digress. Apple's AR directions will display arrow markers on your screen to guide you to your destination. However, this is only going to be available in select cities upon launch of iOS 15, so there's no real word yet on when it'll work across the US, let alone across North America, let alone across the world. So what are you looking forward to the most from iOS 15? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more iOS content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.